What's up, everyone? Kyle here, Mark here, Jenson USA, to bring you the 2023 SB140 first look. All right, Kyle, we know that you handle all things bikes here. You know, you're bringing the bikes in here for Jenson. You are such an expert on everything coming in. We've heard of the SB140 with Yeti, but with the 2023 SB140, we're getting something completely new. Why don't you tell us a little bit about this and, you know, an overview of what Yeti's designing here?
Yeah, so what this is Yeti now at the moment has two models of SB140. They have the 27.5 and now the 29 version. This is now taking the place of the SB130 or SB130 lunch ride. It's just now built with a new platform with 140 mil travel in the rear. Therefore, just going, staying with the name, you know, that Yeti runs through with all their models of travel-wise in the name of the bike. So yeah, this is right now, it's gonna be 23, 140 29 inch version. And also on this platform, instead of having two different travel lengths in the rear, they have the SB140 and the SB140 lunch ride. Both of them are going to have 140 mil travel in the rear. The difference is the 140, it's going to have a 150 fork, and on the lunch ride version, it bumps up to the 160 fork with a grip tube damper, while the 150 travel still uses the Fit 4, and it just has a little bit burpier build kit through it to be able to handle the bigger mountain terrain.
Awesome. So, you know, with the SB140, like, we know where it's aimed for, but with this 29er version, like, what kind of rider is really going to benefit out of getting this 29er option now and this new build with the lunch ride and all that?
So what I really like about this bike is I put a lot of time on the SB130 lunch ride. Love the bike. It's jumped up just a little bit more in travel. You know, the 160 fork was what the lunch ride had before. What I get out of Yeti, out of their engineers, is this bike was actually built to be a lunch ride, as the 130 was built to be the shorter travel. So this was actually platform built to be the longer travel, and then they put the smaller stuff on to go down. So this is gonna put you in that upper trail category. I know the term doesn't get used as much, but it's where I sit, is that all mountain category, really. Those guys that, like, I prefer always like to have a big climb, still love the descent, and I wanna do everything great in between and really enjoy it with one bike. You know, this is really gonna be, you know, to use that term, quiver killer. It really is. It can do about everything and anything in between on this guy. So we're excited this year.
Yeah, you know, the big thing is, like, a lot of guys here at Jenson, a lot of our riders, you know, all of us, like, we're hitting our local trails, but then on the weekends, you know, we're lucky that, you know, here in HQ, we're in Southern California, we can head up to the bike park. You know, how do you see this SB140, like, being able to do that, like you said, that quiver killer, able to go out, hit your local trails, climb way up, get a good ascent, but then also on the weekend, meet up with everyone and go hit the, you know, the bike park in that sense?
Yeah, so that's what's really cool, especially with this new platform, is Yeti now, because these bikes are size specific and chain stay as well as seat tube angle. You know, like, I'm lucky enough that I'm sitting on a medium, and I'm really in that medium height, so bikes fit me pretty well on that. But I can understand, you know, if I rode a smaller bike, how short this would feel. Being able to get those longer chain stays in there for the taller riders that's going through is a big thing. Yeti's also done a lot with making you feel a little bit more centered on this bike. So, the other, you know, other Yetis in the past itself have felt really long in the front, make you feel like you've got to really get over the front of the bars to ride the things that are progressive. This new platform actually centers you a little bit more on the bike. A really good seated position on this. So you're gonna have the ability to still pedal really well, still slack enough head tube angle into this, and a nicer characteristic that you don't feel like you have to just be ripping all the time, that you do still get trouble, some characteristics at it, and you drop that saddle with that lower C2 pipe on there. And you're gonna run up, you know, on this medium here, we have a 175 dropper up to a 200. So you got that full length there and drop it down. For the most of the stuff we have here on our trails, as well as our lift service here, our lift service is a relatively mountain, you know, so this is actually going to be a really good platform. Still have a lot of ability to push down into the travel, get a lot of response back out of it, and still just growing up and be able to handle those full days out there and just do everything and anything between if you wanted to hit up just a little pedal session before we even hit the slopes, you know.
All right, Kyle, so I know that you had the SB130 lunch ride previously, and I mean, you shredded that thing on some races and, you know, really built up like a feeling for that bike. Why don't you tell us a little bit about, you know, how this SB140 is, you know, changing, you know, 2023 with that, and you know, how it meets into your expectations.
Yeah, so I had the pleasure of being able to own the lunch ride for quite some time, and put it through some of our local and dual races and stuff here, and still used it as my trail bike, you know, on the weekend type of thing. So where I really feel like this platform has really gone beyond where that used to be, sort of splitting the hairs of where the new SB160 is and the 150, you're sort of sitting in that in between. So like I said, pushing that boundaries into that all mountain category a little bit more. So in the trail, I do believe the reach in this, as well as the head tube angle, really getting you that little bit more sense of mobility and being able to push it a little bit farther, especially with just a hair bit more travel out of there, but that progression is built into it. This platform, though, over its predecessor, is this frame was actually built around the 140 mil travel in the rear. The 130 or lunch ride version was actually built around the 130 travel and then taken or put a longer stroke on the shock. So it had a compromise. You know, that was what Yeti employees did to be able to ride on the week or on their lunch arms. That's why it's called lunch ride. That's how they wanted to ride the bike. I think what this bike was is really like what I wanted or what those guys really wanted from the stand, the get-go. And this is really where that market trend has taken it. With some of the updates that we're gonna see on this, like, so I'm really excited to see this and put more time on this bike. What you get out of this is, I really love what Yeti's done. It's gone through a threaded bottom bracket out of the Yeti. It's been a long time that we've asked for that. I'm super excited to see that. I've already mentioned, you know, the side-specific chain stays as well as C-cube angles on it. I really do dig the profile of the frame. They've actually taken the profile and cleaned that up quite a bit. Before, it used to dip down quite a bit. You used to get some rock blows into this. It's actually a little bit more clear to it. Aesthetically wise, the profile is just gorgeous. It speaks Yeti. It's 100% a Yeti. And then you see that. They also have a dual density or two-layer bottom protection on this, sort of like a foam case. I actually think it's pretty cool. They have a hard case that wraps all the way through and a softer material that runs on top, so you get a little bit of impact noise taken away, as well as the structural safety out of it. And one of the things that they brought over from the ARC, and I gotta say on most bikes, I really appreciate, I love a quiet bike, is they've actually used these cable managements that you'll see here. They're actually tied down the pinch bolt down on, so it keeps the cables from moving around. You don't get any fluid down in there. And if you're lucky enough to run like a wireless access kit or something like that, it can cap off so you don't get any water in there or anything like that as well. You'll see the mechanical management even on the pivots that are over the chain and stuff that aren't getting sucked in there. So it's just these little fine little minute little things that really set this frame and this bike apart, that you know Yeti's taken a lot of time and a lot of engineering time to really to look into this and really fine-tune it. But again, it's taken them over 2 years to design this frame. And they didn't want to just push something out there on the market. They wanted to make sure that this was something that could stand behind and represent the game.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, it's an exciting bike. I think what they're really bringing to the market here is, you know, a real game changer when it comes to that, you know, like you said, like that all mountain, you know, get out there and, you know, put the bikes, whatever you want to put it on and, you know, enjoy what you're doing. All right, Kyle, thanks for going over this bike with us. We know the SB140 here at Jenson is probably the most hyped bike, even amongst the employees here. A few of us have already, you know, got ready to pre-order this thing and they're excited to get out there on the trails with it. So why don't any of y'all tell us, are you going to SB140? Are you going to SB40 lunch ride? Which travel option is for you? We'd love to hear about it down in the comments. And maybe you have some further questions because you're an enduro rider like Kyle here and you're looking to take this 140 and upgrade and get out there and shred it on some races. Reach out to our Gear Advisor pros. They know everything there is to know about bikes. Trust me, I test them all the time. Anytime I have a question, I ask them, I drill them. It's like pop quiz all the time. And they've never failed me in that sense. So reach out. They love to talk bikes and all that. And as always, because that's what we do here at Jenson, keep pedaling.